James was still shut up in the sheds for being naughty. He hadn't seen the Fat Controller in several days. It was not allowed to even shunt coaches in the yard. Oh dear, he thought, I shall have to stay here forever, and no one shall get to see my lovely coat of red paint again, all because I went too fast and made a hole in one of my coaches. At last, the Fat Controller arrived. I see you are sorry, he said. People are laughing at my railway, and I don't like that. I'm very sorry, sir, said James. Please let me out of the sheds today. Very well, he said. I want you to take some trucks for me. Yes, sir, said James, and off he went. Here you are, James, said Thomas. Have you got some bootlaces ready? And off he ran laughing. Oh, said the trucks. We want a proper engine, not a big red monster. Shut up, said James, and was coupled to the train. Come on, said James. Oh, ow, groaned the trucks, but James went on. The trucks tried everything to make James stop. Sometimes their brakes would slip off. Other times, their axle boxes would run hot. And each time, the trouble had to be put right. James continued on, determined not to let the truck stop him. At last, they came to the hill. Let's go quickly, James, said his driver. If we go fast, we can get them up the hill. The trucks tried everything to stop James. Hold back, they would say. It all came easy. I've done it, said James. Now it's easy. But his driver saw what happened. Because our tail broke away. We must go back for it. The truck stopped at the bottom of a hill. Edward stopped just before bumping into them. Would you like some help, James?
No, thank you, Edward, said James. I can manage.
That's the spirit, said Edward.
I've done it for sure,
said James. And eventually, he came over the hill and went down the other side. Soon, James stopped at the next station.
Well done, James, said the Fat Controller. You are a really useful engine.